Welcome to Maths TV. Today we'll be going through Mathematics Extended Paper 0580, which is Cambridge IGCSE, Paper 2, Specimen Paper 2020. This will be the worked solutions, complete worked solutions, absolutely free. Questions used in this paper are from Cambridge IGCSE, and we have not designed those questions. We are using those questions just for educational purposes. If you want to go through the complete paper, follow the flow of the video. But if you want to go through some specific question, we'll be showing video index, so you can skip to the required question. Thanks. Question number 1. A train leaves Zurich at 22:40 and arrives in Vienna at 7:32 the next day. Work out the time the train takes. So we can solve this question if we understand if this is, for example, time line number like number line. In the middle, if you are taking like 24 hours, 22:40 will be here, 22:40, and 7:32 will be over here. So we'll have to calculate time between 22 hours and 40 minutes and 24 hours. This one we can calculate with the calculator. So on calculator we will solve 24 hours minus 22 hours 40 minutes. So the answer will be 1 hour and 20 minutes. So this duration will be 1 hour and 20 minutes. Now we can calculate this duration, which is obvious, which is 7 hours 32 minutes. So this duration is 7 hours 32 minutes. We can add this time and this time, we will get the total answer. So 1 hour 20 minutes plus 7 hours and 32 minutes, the answer will be 8 hours 52 minutes. Question number 2. In a box of 80 glasses, 3 are broken. So total number of glasses is 80 and broken are 3. Work out the percentage of broken glasses in the box. So 3 out of 80 are broken. So 3 out of 80 multiply by 100 for percentage. So we can calculate by calculator. 3 divided by 80 multiply by 100 will be equal to 3.75%. So we can write 3.75. Question number 3. Here is a list of numbers. Put a ring around the number with the largest value. So what we will do, we will convert everything into decimal numbers so that we can compare them, because they have provided us decimal number, fraction also, and percentage also. So we can write percentage 33% as 33 over 100 33%. So we will convert 1 by 3 by the help of calculator. 1 over 3, and this is 0.333, and which is recurring. So, and 3 divided by 10 will be 0.3. So this is 0.3. Now we can convert 33%, which is 33/100, which is 0.33. Now everything we have converted into decimal numbers. We can now compare. First of all, we will compare the first digit after the decimal, which is 3 here in this case, here in this case also 3, 3, and 3. So this one is first decimal number is 0, so this number is out of race. We can cross this one. Now we need the largest number, so now we will compare the second decimal place value, which is 0 in this case, 3 in this case, and 3 in this case. So this one is out of race, this is also out of race, because these two are not having proper comparison for second decimal place. Now we can compare this one and this one. This is having 0.33, but this is up to 2 decimal place. There's no 3 decimal place. This one is 3 decimal place plus it's recurring also. So this is the largest number. So we can circle 1 by 3. This is our answer. Question number 4. Chai says that 8 centimeter square is the same as 80 millimeter squares. This is unit conversion question. Explain why Chai is wrong. So if we convert 8 centimeter square, 8 centimeter squares, we can write 8 centimeter into centimeter. Now we have to convert both centimeters into millimeters. So what we can do, we can write as 8, 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters. 8 multiply by 10. Why 10? Because centimeter, 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters. So now this centimeter is converted into millimeters. Now we can convert this also. 10 millimeters like this. So we'll write this 8 in 10 into 10 will be 800 millimeters. Hence 8 centimeter square will be equal to 800 millimeters. So we can write that 100 millimeter square is equal to 1 centimeter square. This is the reason why this Chai is wrong. Question number 5. Y is equal to mx plus c. This is equation of line in slope intercept form. Find the value of y when m is equal to minus 2, x is equal to minus 7, and c is equal to minus 3. Basically, all three values are given. We have to replace these values in the given equation, y is equal to mx plus c. So we will write y is equal to m, which is minus 2, x, which is minus 7, plus c, which is minus 3. We will replace values in brackets so that we are not going to make any mistake. So minus 2 multiplied by minus 7 will be 14, plus 14 minus plus minus multiplication with minus, so minus 3, this will be plus 11. So y is equal to 11 is the answer. Y is equal to 11. Question number 6. The number of cars parked in a car park at 9 a.m. is recorded for 10 days. So these are the numbers, data is given. and key is provided over here. 123 we will write like this. 12 will be on this side and 3 we will write on this side. So they have provided us the format how to write 123, and this key we will be utilizing. For example, first number is 124, so first two digit we will use will go to 12, and this 4 we can copy over here. Next number is 130, so quickly we will go to the 13, and 0 we will write over here. Next number is 129, again we will go to 12 and we will write here 9. Next number is 116, so we will go to 11, because first two digits are 11 according to key. We are utilizing the first two numbers, so 6 we will write over here. Next is 132, so we will check for 13 and we will write here 2. Then 120, we'll go for 12 for first two numbers and we will write 0 over here. 127, again we'll have to go to 12 and write here 7. Next number is 107, so we'll go to 10 and write here 7. Next number is 118, so we'll go to 11 and write here 8. 114, so we will look for 11 and write here 4. This will be our final answer. Question number 7. Using a ruler and pair of compasses only, construct a triangle with sides 5 cm, 8 cm and 10 cm. Leave in your construction arcs. So we will take the bigger value, bigger length as a base. 10 cm we will draw as a base. For example, we can take 10 cm as base over here, and this is 10 cm. We can name it as A and B, 10 cm. This will be base of 10 cm. Now we can draw 5 cm one side. So we'll take pair of compasses and we'll open this 5 cm. Like this one, and draw an arc from B. We can draw an arc 5 cm like this, and the other side is 8 cm. So we'll open the compass exactly 8 cm. And after opening 8 cm, we'll place here at A and make another arc of 8 cm like this one. We'll get a point of intersection between these two arcs, and this point of intersection we can name it as C. We'll join B with C. Like this one. And we also join A with C. A with C. Now this is the complete triangle. BC is 5 cm. We label the triangle 5 cm and 8 cm. Question number 8. Diagram is provided. Triangle ABC is isosceles. AC is parallel to BD. AC is parallel to BD. Find the value of A and B. If you check this triangle ABC, this triangle is isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle means it's having two sides equal. This side is equal to this side. So opposite angles will be equal. Opposite angle of this side is A, and opposite angle of this side is this one. So these two angles will be equal to each other. As the total angle of interior angle of this triangle is 180, so 180 minus 40 degree, this 40 degree, 180 minus 40 degree will be equal to 140 degree, which is these two angles. 140 degree is divided into two equal portions, and this angle and this angle will be equal to 140. So we'll divide this 140 by 2 and we will get 70 degree. So this angle A is equal to 70 degree. Angle A is equal to 70 degree. Now in this triangle, we know AC is parallel to BD. Hence this angle C will be equal to this angle B. As C is 40, so B will also be 40. So we will write here 40 degrees. Question number 9. Rearrange the formula 5W minus 3Y plus 7 is equal to 0 to make W as the subject. So W we have to make subject. So we will shift rest of everything to the other side of equality. 3y also and 7 also will shift to other side. So we'll get the 5w is equal to 3y minus 7. Now we can divide both sides by 5 to get rid of this 5. So this will be cancelled. W will be equal to 3y minus 7 over 5. This will be our answer. We will copy this answer over here. 3y minus 7 over 5. Question number 10. Explain why under root 3 is irrational. We know irrational numbers are the numbers which cannot be written as fraction. So we write under root 3 cannot be written as a fraction. Question number 11. The mass m kilograms of a horse is 429 kilogram. Write the nearest, correct to the nearest kilometer. Correct to the nearest kilometer. Complete this statement about the value of m. This is basically lower bound and upper bound. So we will write lower bound and upper bound of 429 kilogram. So upper bound and lower bound. Upper bound and lower bound. Upper bound of 429 will be 429.5 and lower bound will be 428.5. We are reducing half kilogram, half of the unit, which is kilogram. So half of kilogram we will reduce for lower bound, and we will add half kilogram for upper bound. So the bigger value will be 429.5, which is the upper bound, and the smaller value will be 428.5. This is how we will fill the answer portion. Question number 12. Triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. These two triangles are similar to each other, so they must be having conversion factor. This side is converting to this side. 12.4 is converting to 21.7. So we will check with calculator. 21.7 divided by 12.4. This will be the value of K. By calculator, we will check what is the conversion factor. So we will divide 21.7 divided by 12.4. This will be equal to 1.75. So this is 1.75 is the conversion factor. Now we have to convert 5.2 into PQ side. So we will multiply by conversion factor. 5.2 multiply by 1.75 will be, let us check with the calculator. 5.2 multiply by 1.75 will be equal to 9.1, because units are centimeters, so we will be writing centimeters, 9.1 centimeter. Question number 13, solve the inequality. This inequality is given, we have to solve. So we'll shift n on one side, terms with n on one side, and the other constants we will shift to the other side of equality, inequality. So this is inequality, we'll shift n to this side. So 5n minus n, and this side is having 7 minus 8, we will shift to this side. So this will change to plus 8. So 8 plus 7 plus 8 plus 7. Now 8 plus 7 will be 15, is less than, this will be 4n, 5n minus 1n will be 4n. We can divide both sides by plus 4. So dividing by a plus number will not be having effect on inequality. So we'll keep the direction of inequality as it is. So n is greater than 15 by 4. 15 by 4 can be written as 3.75. We can check with the calculator. 15 divided by 4 will be equal to 3.75. So we can write down answer at the proper place, 3.75. Question number 14, without using your calculator, work out this mixed fraction. We'll have to add in a fraction. You must show all your working and give your answer as a mixed number. The answer they are requiring in mixed number in its simplest form. So it's 3-mark question, so you will have to be careful in providing the proper mixed number also, and in simplified form also. So what we will do, we will change this mixed fraction into improper fraction. So 1 whole 7 by 12, we will change, we will multiply 1 with 12 and plus 7 will be 19. So this will be equal to 19 by 12. And this is 13 over 20 plus 13 over 20. So now what we have to do, we'll have to make denominators equal. Denominators are 12 and 20. So we can change both of them into 60. So we'll multiply 19 by 5. And 12 also by 5, numerator and denominator will be multiplying with the same number, and plus this side will be multiplied by 3, so that we can change denominator to 60. So we'll multiply numerator and denominator both by 3. So we will get 19 multiply by 5 will be 95. So we will write 95 divided by 60 plus 13, 3s are will be 39 divided by 60. Now, as denominators are equal, we can add numerators. So 95 plus 39 will be 134 divided by 60, which can be written as 1 whole 74 over 60, or you can write it as 2 whole 14 over 60. 14 over 60 can be cancelled, and your simplified final answer will be 2 whole 7 by 30. This will be your final answer. Question number 15. Here is a sequence of numbers. 7, 5, 3, 1, minus 1, and next is blank. A part is find the next term in the sequence. So if we check, we are getting next term by subtracting 2. So 5 is changing to 3 by subtracting another 2. So each term is shifting to next one by subtracting 2. So similarly, if we subtract 2 from minus 1, so we will get minus 3. So the next term required answer for A part is minus 3. B part, find an expression for the nth term of the same sequence. So we can check this one, 9 minus 2n will be the nth term. If we replace n is equal to 1, we will get n minus 9 minus 2, which will be 7. If we replace 2, because difference is minus 2, you know how we are finding the nth term. We will be multiplying the difference with n, and then we'll be checking how we can get the first term. So we'll multiply minus 2 with n, and then for first term we will replace n is equal to 1, and we will check what we are getting. So this 9 minus 2n will be the nth term, 9 minus 2n. In this nth term questions, always remember that you will have to double check. You will have to replace at least 3 or 4 values, like for example first term, second term, third term, fourth term. At least 3-4 terms you will have to replace and check. For first term, replace n is equal to 1. For second term, replace n is equal to 2 and check whether you are getting 5 or not. And for third term, replace n is equal to 3 and you should get 3 in this case. And for fifth term, for example, if you replace n is equal to 5, you should get minus 1. If you are getting 3 or 4 terms properly, it means your nth term formula is working. Question number 16. A hexagon has 5 angles that each measure 115 degrees. Calculate the size of 6th angle. We know the formula for finding the interior angle, sum of interior angles, number of sides n minus 2. N minus 2, n in this case is 6 because hexagon. So 6 minus 2 multiplied by 180 will be equal to, if we use calculator, So 6 minus 2 multiplied by 180. 6 minus 2 multiplied by 180. Will be equal to 720. 720. So total angle of hexagon, interior angle, sum of interior angles of hexagon is 720. So 5 angles are 115 each. So 5 multiplied by 115 will be equal to 115 multiplied by 5 will be equal to 575. 575. Now the sixth angle will be 720 minus 720 minus 575. You can check with calculator, it will be 145 degrees. So our answer will be 145 degrees. Question number 17. Calculate the area of this trapezium. The provided trapezium is having one side 8 cm, the other side is 12 cm. But we need perpendicular height, which is AD, which is not provided. Slanting height is provided, which is 8 cm. So we will find the perpendicular height. What we can do, we can join this C with point E. We can mark this point as E. Now we will apply Pythagoras' theorem on this triangle, on this shaded triangle. And hypotenuse is 8 cm. This base will be 12 minus 8, which will be 4. So EB will be 4 cm. Now we will apply Pythagoras' theorem, which is hypotenuse square will be equal to base square plus perpendicular square. Now we can replace the values. Let us suppose this CE is X. So hypotenuse, which is 8 square will be equal to base square, which is 4 square plus X square. Now we can find the value of X square, which is 8 square minus 4 squared. So value of X will be equal to under root of 8 squared minus 4 squared. So now we can use calculator to find the value of this X. So under root 8 squared minus 4 squared will be equal to 4 under root 3. So this X value is 4 under root 3. Now we got the perpendicular height, which is 4 under root 3. Now we can find area of trapezium. Area of trapezium will be equal to 1 by 2 a plus b into h. A plus b are the opposite sides and h is the perpendicular height. So we'll replace the values 1 by 2 into a, which is 8 centimeters plus 12 centimeters, multiplied by 4 under root 3, which is perpendicular height. Now we will use calculator to find this value. 1 over 2 multiplied by 8 plus 12 multiplied by 4 under root 3. This will be equal to 40 under root 3. In decimal notation, we can get 69.28. So, which is answer 69.28 centimeter square. Question number 18. Shade the region in each of Venn diagrams below. A part. A complement union B. So if we draw separate drawings, for example, I'll draw small drawings for you. For example, this one. This is A. This one is B. We will try to draw A complement. A complement. A complement mean whatever not in A. A complement, I will shade A complement. This shaded region will be A complement. This is all A complement. Now B, if we draw another Venn diagram, A and B, for example A, B, now I will shade only B. B is this one, so I will shade B. Now we need union A complement union B. Whatever shaded union mean, you'll have to unite. So whatever shaded in both. In both mean whatever shaded in this one or this one. So shaded in this or shaded in this will be included. So I will shade in this diagram whatever shaded in this or in this. That will be, this is B. So shading in this one, I will shade over here. This one I have transferred a complement shading over here. This is a complement shading. Now I will include B shading also, which is this part additionally. So I will shade this region also. So this one is a complement union B. This will be our answer. So if we draw these type of separate portions like A complement and B, it will be easier for us to complete this drawing. Now B part. B part is D intersection E. D intersection E complement. And F intersection with this complement. So we'll try to draw D intersection E complement first. So if I draw another Venn diagram for you, which is this one, D, E and F. So this is D, this is E. And this one F. So D intersection E, whatever common in both D intersection E. So first I will draw D intersection E. So common in D and E is this portion. Now if we draw complement of D intersection E, whatever not shaded in this will be D intersection E complement. D intersection E complement. This one. D, E and F. D, E and F. So whatever not shaded in this one, we will shade. This portion is not shaded in this, so I will shade the whole portion this side. This side also. So this side. So leaving only this portion, we'll shade everything. So we have left only this region, which is D intersection E. Only this is white portion, rest of everything is shaded. This is our D intersection E complement. Now we'll take intersection of this one with F. If we want to draw only F, this will be our D, this will be our F, E, and this one will be our F. D, E, and F. So if we shade only F, this portion will be shaded. Now we need intersection between this one, D intersection E complement, and this one, which is F. Okay, we need intersection between these two drawings. So intersection mean common in both. Common in both, we'll see common in both will be whatever shaded in both will be this region. This region will be shaded. If you check, this portion is shaded in both drawings. This one is shaded in both drawings. Plus this side is also shaded in both drawings. So we can shade the portion which is shaded in both. This will be our answer. Question number 19. Use the calculator to find the decimal value of this provided fraction. So this is basically calculator usage question. So we'll write in calculator fraction under root 29 minus 3 multiplication 32 raised to the power 0.4 divided by 3 will be equal to, this will be equal to under root 17 over 3, and the decimal value of this one will be 1.37 4, and which is recurring. So our answer will be 1.37. Question number 20. Write the recurring decimal 0.32 recurring as a fraction. You must show all your working. So what we will do, we can write x is equal to 0.32, which is recurring. Now 10x will be equal to 0.32 recurring multiplied by 10, which will be equal to 3.2, which is recurring. Now 100x will be 3.2 recurring multiplied by 10, or we can take this one and multiply by 100. So we will take x value for your understanding. Better to take x value 0.32 recurring multiplied by 100. this will be equal to 32.2 recurring. Now we can subtract these two values, so 100x minus 10x will be equal to 32.2 recurring minus 3.2 recurring. So recurring portion, this will cancel out because this will be subtraction, so this side will be 90x is equal to 32 minus 3, which will be 29, and now you can see recurring portion is subtracted and removed. Now we can divide both sides by 90, so x will be equal to 29 divided by 90, which is not having a recurring portion, so our answer will be in fraction, which is required, which is 29 divided by 90. So we have written decimal 0.32 recurring as a fraction, and we have shown all the working also. Hopefully you will understand everything. Question number 21. The diagrams A, B, C, D, E and F are 6 graphs of different functions. They have provided us with 6 different graphs of different functions, and they have provided also with the equations of the functions. So for example, if you can see this one, complete the table to identify the correct graph for each function. One has been done for you. So the first graph is done, which is this one, y is equal to x plus 1, and this they have provided us the answer for the diagram E. This equation is for E, and E is this one. So we'll have to identify these 3 equations. If you check this, if you will have to keep in mind the equation y is equal to mx plus c, which is equation of line in slope intercept form. C will be y intercept and m will be the slope. Now if you check this equation, y is equal to 1 minus x over 3. In this case, y-intercept is 1. So our line is passing through value 1. So what we will do, we will check the portions. This graph is not related to this equation because graph function is not passing through y-intercept 1. So we will check this graph can be answer because this equation is passing, this line is passing through y-intercept 1. So this can be answer. If we check other graphs, so the other provided graphs are this one. So this first A can be answer because this is also passing through y-intercept 1. So this can be answer, or this can be answer for this equation. But if you see, the equation provided is having slope minus value of slope is indicating that it is sloping downward. So if we check this graph and this line and this line, this is positive slope. This line is going upward, it is having positive slope, whereas this line is having negative slope. So we reject this, only this can be the answer. So this is A part, we will write here for the equation provided, answer will be A. Now we will check the second equation, y is equal to 2x square. Y is equal to 2x square, so it's a squared graph. So this shows that y-intercept is 0, because nothing here. You can write plus 0, so this is 0, y-intercept is 0, so it's passing through origin. Square graphs, x square, squared graphs are only these two, this one and this one, B and C. But we can't take B because the minimum value, this one, is not at origin in this case. So function is not passing through origin in this case, and this is passing through origin, so we'll take this option, which is C, for this provided equation, y is equal to 2x squared. So we'll write here C. Now for the last equation, y is equal to minus 4 over x, so we can take for this one, if you check, 1 over x graph is this and this, these two graphs are 1 over x graph, so this is minus value, which is indicating that graph will be on these two sides. So we'll reject this and we'll take this one. So we'll write answer as D. Question number 22. A soccer team plays two matches. The tree diagram shows the probability of the team winning or losing the matches. This is the first match. You can take it as first draw in probability, and this is the second match, which can be taken as second option, second draw. So first event will be this one, second event will be this one. So the question is, find the probability that the soccer team wins at least one of the two matches, one of the two at least. So in case of probability, question wording is very important. At least one mean one or more than one wins are included. So what we will do, we'll check the probability of ones. For example, see, this one is win, this is win, so this will be included, win and loss. This will also be included because one is win, so these both are included. This will be included, loss and win. Only excluded will be loss and loss. Like if team is losing both matches at first level and second level, both are lost, then you can exclude. So only this option will be excluded, which will be this multiplied by this. So 2 over 3 multiplied by 1 by 4, this will be equal to 2 over 12. So we will be excluding the remaining. The total probability will be 1. So 1 minus 2 over 12. So what we can do, we can use equivalent equalizing denominator method. So 1 can be written as 12 over 12 minus 2 over 12. Now denominators are equal. Now we can subtract the numerators. 10 minus 12 minus 2 will be 10. So 10 over 12, this will be our answer. 10 over 12, this will be the probability for at least one of the two matches. Question number 23. AB is an arc of circle. AB, this one, is arc of the circle. Center O, radius 9 cm. The length of the arc AB is 6 pi. Length of the arc is 6 pi. So this length is 6 pi provided to us. The area of the sector OAB is k pi in terms of pi, it is k pi centimeter square. Find the value of k. So we have to find this value of k. What we will do, we will use this length of the arc is 6 pi. We know formula for length of arc is length is equal to theta over 360 into 2 pi r. R value of r is given, which is 9 centimeter. Theta we don't know, but value of l is given, which is 6 pi. So we will replace the values. 6 pi is equal to theta over 360 into 2 pi. Value of r is 9, so we'll replace here 9. Now we can shift, we can make theta as subject, so theta will be on one side, other side will be 6 pi over 360, this one, sorry, 6 pi over 2 pi into 9 and multiply by 360, because this will go as numerator. Now if we solve this one, we can cancel this pi with pi, and rest of the things we can solve with the calculator, and we will get 120 degrees. Now you can use calculator also and check this value is giving angle 120 degrees. Now we will use this theta value to find the value area of this sector. Area will be this shaded portion. So area of this sector is, formula for area is equal to theta over 360 into pi r squared. So now we can replace the values. 120 will be this value of theta divided by 360, which is by formula, multiplied by pi. R square mean 9 square. So if you use calculator to simplify the fraction excluding pi, so you can simplify with calculator. 120 divided by 360 multiply by 9 square, so the answer will be 27 pi. So they are asking for value of k, which is k pi, so we will not write 27 pi, we will write only 27 over here, because value of k is 27 only, excluding pi. Question number 24. These box and whisker plots show the monthly electricity costs for 100 different households who use electro company or spark company. So this plot is given for electro, this is for electro company, this is for spark company. Monthly cost in dollars. Tom says that the monthly cost with electro company has a lower and very less, lower and very less than with spark company. Is Tom correct? So for value lower, we will check the median. For cheaper and cost-wise costly company, we will check the median value. Median value is this one. In case of spark company, this median value is 46. 46 in, because this is 40, each small box is equal to 2, so this will be the 46th position. And if we check for electro company,
this will be the 52 position. So for this one it is 52. So for electro company median value is 52, whereas for spark company median value is 46. So we will write median is greater, median is greater for electro company . So Tom is wrong. So Tom is wrong. Because Spark company is cheaper. Our company is cheaper. Now the next thing we have to check about the variation, which one is varying less, which one is varying less. For variation we are comparing interquartile IQR, interquartile range is greater for Spark company . Interquartile is more in case of Spark company. So Tom is right. So Tom is right. Spark is more varied. Spark is more varied. You can check. Tom is right. Spark is more varied. If we check variation of Spark company, variation of Spark company is this much region. We can shade this whole region. This is the variation of Spark company, which is 26. From this point is 26. Whereas electro company variation is this much. So variation in case of electro company is lesser, which is 18. This much is 18, whereas this much is 26. Question number 25. Find the turning point of this function by completing square. So we'll have to use the method completing square. So what we will do, we can write y is equal to x square plus 4x minus 3. We will complete square. Method of complete square is we will write x plus half of this one. Half of this one is 2. So we will write this as square and minus the same, which is this one, as square. This is a method for completing square, and this minus 3 we will write as it is. Now this one will be x plus 2 squared minus, this will be 4 minus 3, which can be written as x plus 2 squared minus 7. Now in this format, this one, value of this value of A will be equal to 2, this is value of A, and value of B will be equal to 7, this is value of B. So A and B are these values. The point will be minus A and minus B, so we'll write minus 2 and minus 7. This will be the point, x and y value, minus 2 and minus 7. Question number 26. This diagram is provided, basically this is circle theorem question. A, B, C, D are points. A, B, C, D are points on the circumference of the circle, so it's cyclic quadrilateral. The line XY is a tangent to the circle at A, so this line is tangent at point A. A part, find the value of X, giving a reason for your answer. So if you see, this is the X which we have to find. So if you see, this is equal to this angle because this is alternating segment. So in case of this angle will be equal to this. In case of alternate segment, we can write it x is equal to 55. So this will be 55 degree. Reason, we can write alternate segment. Now for B part, find the value of Y, giving a reason for your answer. And for B part, value of Y we have to find. If you see the diagram, this is Y and this is cyclic quadrilateral, as we discussed. A, B, C, D is cyclic quadrilateral. In case of cyclic quadrilateral, opposite angles are adding up to 180 degree. So these two are opposite angles, they must add up to 180 degree. This angle is 65, so remaining will be 180 minus 65. 180 minus 65 will be value of Y, which is 115. So we can write value of Y as 115. And the reason, we can write cyclic quadrilateral. Question number 27. Simplify this given number. So we'll use calculator for this. Basically, this is also calculator usage question. So, or otherwise, because this is variable x, so we can solve it as 27. We can separate power for this one, and x raised to 6 whole raised to 1/3, we can write like this. Now we can use calculator to find this. So this will be 27 raised to the power 1 divided by 3 will be equal to 3. So answer for this one, by the help of calculator, we can find 3. And this one we can write 6 into 1/3, and this will be 3x raised to, this will be 3 2s are 6, so x square. So answer for this will be 3x squared. Question 27, B part, find the value of this expression. So we can change this one as 64 separately raised to power 0.5 and x4 raised to power 0.5, into, we can write 1 over, we can write 4 over x raised to power 2, because we are shifting this numerator to denominator, so its sign will change. Now 64 raised to the power 0.2, we can write 64 raised to the power 0.5 will be 8. So this will be 8. By the help of calculator we can solve this, and this one we can write x 4 into 0.5 and multiply by 4 over x squared. So 8 can be multiplied by 4, this will be 32, and x raised to the power 4 multiplied by 0.5, we can solve with calculator, this will be 4 multiplied by 0.5, this will be 2, and multiply by 1 over x squared. So these two will be cancelled, so answer will be 32. We can write as 32. So our answer is this. Question number 28. Solve the simultaneous equations. You must show all your working. So equation, we can name it as equation 1 and this one as equation 2. Now we can equate them. We can write y, for example this one, first equation, both are equal to y, so we can equate them. 5x squared plus 4x minus 19 is equal to 4x plus 1. This is equal to this, because left side is equal, so right side will also be equal. So next we can send everything to one side, to this side. So for example, 5x squared plus 4x minus 19, we will shift this also to other side, so minus 4x minus 1 equal to 0. This plus 4x and minus 4x will cancel, and our equation will become 5x square minus 20 is equal to 0. Now we can shift 20 to other side, 5x square will be equal to 20, divide both sides by 5, so this is cancelled, we will get 4. So x squared will be equal to 4. Now we can take under root on both sides, so this will be cancelled, x is equal to plus minus 2. Now x value can be plus 2 or minus 2, we can replace here plus 2 and minus 2. These are the two x values. Now we will replace these two values in any of these two equations, so it's better to replace in equation 2. So equation 2 implies y is equal to, we first we replace plus 2, so 4 into 2 plus 1 which is equal to 8 plus 1 which is equal to 9. So when we replace value of 2 as x as 2, we'll get 9, value of y as 9. Now we will replace x is equal to minus 2, so y will be 4 into minus 2 plus 1 which is minus 8 plus 1 which is equal to minus 7. So we'll write minus 7 over here.
Thanks for watching Maths TV. See you next time with a new mathematics paper with complete worked solutions.